Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. In this video, I will talk a bit more about joint motions and joint targets. Let's get started. In a previous video regarding teach on surface, I briefly touched on the usage of joint targets for approach or home positions. My goal here is to clarify and add a bit more information on that specific topic. So here we have our station that we've been using for the last few tutorials. So I'm going to simply bring my robot somewhere like that. I'm just trying to figure out a position that makes sense. I'm going to move here. Perfect. So that's great. Cool. That will be my home position. I'm going to create my home position within the robot base frame. So two methods to do that, as I already told you, either I just select it as I did or right click and activate it. Both would bring the target right here. So as you can see, by default, the target is red here, meaning that it's a Cartesian target. Right now you have a warning sign telling you that this target isn't reachable. The real thing is that it's not reachable as a relative motion if you try to reach it with part frame one activated. So what you want to do is right click and activate this one, and now you will see that this target is reachable. The fact that it's red means that it's a Cartesian target, so that means that if you right click and more options, what will prevail in any cases is the relative Cartesian position with respect to the first parent or direct parent. So in this case, the robot base. If I was to either right click and then join target or keep joint values here like that, what will now prevail is the robot joints. Meaning that even if I was to change the reference frame position or robot position, the actual configuration or position of the robot arm, so the joint values, wouldn't change and those would be applied directly. That also means that if I decide to create a go home program, so let's go here. First of all, I'm going to recall this one. So press F2, home. I'm going to create a program called here, go home. And I will select this one here. I will create a joint motion like that. So now from anywhere, I will reach this position here. So that's great. This means that even if I was to, let's say, make that home position instead of being part of the frame here, if I make it part of frame part, let's say, if I run it like that, it will be there. It doesn't matter which frame is active here. In this case, it's a joint target. So the only thing that matters is making sure that the joint values here do match with the joint values here. So it's the case. Doesn't matter if I change here for another frame part, it will go to the same exact spot. If I right click here, part two, run this one, exact same spot. Because here what prevails is not the relative position, it's the joint values. So let's add our go home to the general program. So I'm going to add here, right click, add instruction, program call instruction. I will simply enter, in this case, go home. I could have picked it up from the select program. Click OK. Gonna bring that on top here. So go home, just after cutting, go home, and then after call, control V, go home. So now if I run that here, main cutting, I will go run the first program. And then go in and then run the second one. So that's cool. That's perfect. What I can do is I can even get rid of those, because the neither the frame nor the tool active tool will have any impact on the program that is actively run in this case. So that's great. One thing that I want to show you real quick that can have some, I wouldn't say weird effect, but you can see some, you can have some visual misrepresentation if some of your targets are joint targets. I'm going to add a new frame. I will make it part of the robot base, let's say here. I want it to be back at zero. So let's say I'm going to right click and reset. So as you remember, if I right click and then reset, everything here becomes zero. I'm going to use my scroll wheel to move it up a bit. In this case here, I know that the table is at like -330. I can see it from here. By the way, what I can do is reference frame position with respect to. I can see the reference frame with respect to robot base. So here by default, it was with respect to the first direct parent, which in this case was the station. So it's -333. So I'm going to go here and control C, control V that here. So that will make frame 4 exactly where the table is. So this frame will be called parts. You will understand where I'm going with that. And then I want part and part 2 to be part of parts. So I'm going to right click, change support parts for part 1 or part 2. Okay, and same for part 2. I want it to be part of parts. By the way, I'm going to rename this one here part 1 to remove any confusion. First of all, this is something that you need to be aware of. If you were using part frame somewhere, it's the same if you change the name of a target that you were using. The naming here won't be updated. If you were to right click set reference frame link, you would see that the naming here would be updated, but the actual name in the station tree won't, unless you click once more on it. Now it will actively update the naming. Let's hope this will be added later in RoboDK. So now I can go and see the position of those part frames. So I'm going to just make it 0 and 150 just to have a specific position. I'll do the same with the second one. So 0 here and 500, let's say. Perfect. So now if I run my main program, it will go and run on those two parts. If I was to move that here, by the way, I can move in real time and it will kind of follow the new part. In this case, I just placed it at a place where that doesn't make any sense. So I'm just gonna rerun it at a better spot. The point is, just like that, I can move my bundle of two or more parts, because here I have one frame parts with within it the different subframe part. And if I move them, the program will follow. But as you can see here, the home position, the representation of the home position does move, but the actual point that the robot reach do not, because it still goes back to the joint positions and not the relative position. So even if home is here right now, it will still reach this point here. If you want that to be any other way, you need to take the robot and bring it to, let's say here, right click home and then teach current position. Now it will overwrite the joint values that you already had in your program. Okay, so that's pretty much everything for this video. I hope you found it helpful. In the next one, we will remove here our generic tool and add a new custom tool from scratch. So that's a very important step in the creation of your RoboDK station, being able to import custom tool, add the TCP at the right spot, and then use it for your program. So that's the main topic of the next video. Hope to see you there. Have a great day, guys.